still sounded pretty calm when he talked about his future yesterday. Take a listen.
It's really the reality for most guys in the NFL. You know, I don't want to think that I'm any different than everyone else. Like, it's football's a tough business. It's a production business. And, you know, I'm ready to go this year. And that's really what matters. And that's where my focus is. It's a unique situation I'm in. You know, I'm 20th year with the same team. And, you know, be 42 years old. So pretty much uncharted territory, I think, for everybody. And, you know, I'm going to go out there and do the best I can this year and see what happens.
Well, Shannon, what do those comments from Brady tell you?
Yeah, Shannon, what do they tell you?
All the way there, you give, I could have sworn. Now, somebody sat up here yesterday and saw that Tom Brady had gotten a 2-year, $70 million extension.
Sure.
And I said, now, if I'm not mistaken, I could have swore I said, Skip, that don't mean anything. Because I've never heard of someone getting a $70 million extension and only getting $8 million signing bonus. I said, this is year to year. Oh, no, he go play. You know,
I didn't disagree with the year to year, but I also he's going to play till he's 45. Yeah. Period. End of story. You've been wrong 3 straight years. You're going to be wrong.
Hold on.
Go ahead.
Before we go any further.
Yep.
We're not debating. Okay, I still don't. I said, what did I say, Skip? In New England. Now, Coach Belichick has already tried to jettison him.
He did.
And his daddy had to come. He went upstairs, called his dad on the phone, because he the only one got dad phone. You know, everybody don't have him.
Yeah.
He called his dad. Coach Belichick tried to get rid of his daddy. And his dad came down there and put his foot down. And Billy.
Who was right there? Was Daddy or Belichick right?
You know, Mr. Kraft.
Who was right? I think Daddy was really right on that one.
Coach Belichick, Mr. Kraft calls him Bill. Skip, this is a 1-year deal, basically. And all he did was get, and rightfully so, Skip, they should have gave him probably $20 million a raise this year. He should be making $40 million. Kind of be like Jordan. His last couple of years, pay him all the money that you saved by having him play under that under market value. But, Skip, this is, look, once you get to his age, they cannot afford to have Tom Brady give him, so let's just say for the sake of argument, Skip, they gave him a 3-year, $90 million extension and gave him, say, $40, $45, $50 million guaranteed. Have him step off a cliff and he retire, and then all that money then they're in salary cap hell the next couple of years. That's not the way the Patriots operate. Skip, also, I think the biggest thing that what they do in New England is that they play a mental game Monday through Saturday. And when you get on the field on Sunday, it's a relief. You see what they're doing? Skip, that's Tom Brady. They're playing on a year-to-year contract. Now, that's not Joe Blow. That's not a guy that's a fringe guy that he may or may not make the roster.
Yep.
Most people consider him the GOAT. 6 Super Bowls, 4 MVPs, I think 3 league MVPs. And he's playing on a year-to-year contract.
Yep.
But it also goes to show you, Skip, when you see these conflated numbers. Oh, he got 5-year extension for $118 million and 42 cents. They mean nothing. Because once you weave away and you start reading the fine print, what is it, Skip? It's basically he got an $8 million raise this year. He's going to make $23 million. The deal, boys, after the season, then we'll see you. Okay, Tom, Skip, for me, I don't know how you read that video, but it didn't look like a guy that was really, really happy near the genie. I'm going to play my best, and we'll see what happens after that. That doesn't seem like a guy that was enthused. They're not as interested in Tom Brady playing until he's 45 as Tom is interested in him playing until he's 45.
Interesting. No, I think it's a terrible point, but that's...
I'm about to shoot big holes in that point.
Okay, go ahead.
I get what you're saying. Before I launch, before I unleash on everything you just said, frame this with the fact that your quarterback, Carson Wentz, we're going to discuss him in detail in just a few minutes.
Yes.
Carson Wentz just got $108 million guaranteed over a long stretch of time. He's got long-term security.
He got a 4 or 5 extensions.
And they are stuck with Carson Wentz. Yeah, limp it to him, Wentz. Can he stay healthy? So just frame this with the fact he's got long-term security. Nobody in this league has more guaranteed money on his current deal than Carson Wentz of the Philadelphia Eagles.
Correct.
Just for perspective. Back to Tom Brady. He proved to you yesterday he is a one and only. Once again, what Tom Brady said yesterday was so Tom Brady. It summed up everything Tom Brady because he just told you I don't even want any security. I don't want to work with a safety net like everybody else.
Yes, he does.
I would prefer to do it this way because this way only motivates Tom Brady at age 42. And you know what it smacked of to me? It reminded me so much of my years around Michael Jeffrey Jordan in Chicago. That was the end of his prime run with the Bulls. He was constantly trying to trick himself into new motivations as he won his third championship. Then it led to a fourth, fifth, and sixth. Each year, he needed a new motivation.
Okay.
So he often fictionalized feuds with various players who would say, I don't even know what he's talking about. I didn't mean that way.
Right.
And Michael would take it very personally. I'm going to show you. I'm going to take it out on you. Mm-hmm. And then he spent the whole last year with the Bulls trying to take it out on Jerry Krause, who deserved it because he was trying to bring Tim Floyd in from Iowa State to replace Phil Jackson.
He didn't deserve it. Stop.
Okay. So Michael took it so personally, he dedicated all of 1998 to putting little Jerry Krause back in his place. This is classic Jordan-esque Tom Brady saying, I need motivation at age 42. So he said, well, I've got security for this year. And then the dot, dot, dot. I think, that's what he said. I think, he said, at least I'm getting some first-team reps out there. He's talking about himself like he's still a sixth-round draft pick trying to make the football team.
And they put him on a contract like he's a sixth-round draft pick.
That is correct. That's
trying
correct.
To make the team.
And did he hold out? Did he go to Cabo? No, he's not going to do that.
Stop it. Stop
okay?
it, Skip.
That's and,
a totally
and he even
situation.
Said, you can't, and it's written in his contract, according to all the reports, you can't franchise tag me next year. So he's basically, there's going to be a moment
yes.
when he's going to be free. Okay, at age 42, going on 43, yep. he will, at least for like 1 minute, be a free agent till daddy steps in and says, what can we do about next year, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so here you have Tom Brady with 6 Super Bowl rings telling the world, you know, he says, I'm good because this is the key line. He said, it's really the reality for most guys in the NFL. I don't want anyone to think I'm any different from everyone else.
So you can't be a GOAT.
Wow.
GOATs are
interesting.
Different.
Interesting.
Hold on, Skip. You said Tom Brady said he don't.
You're missing how he becomes the GOAT continues to be the GOAT. Motivation.
I'm not, hold on.
Treat me like a sixth rounder.
Hey, guess what? You keep talking about Michael Jordan, how he tried to constantly find motivation, but his last 2 years, what did they pay him, Skip Bayless?
In Chicago?
Yes.
Not that much.
Skip,
he was still way underpaid.
Skip, he was making 30.
He was the biggest steal in the history of basketball.
Okay, but Skip, he was $10, $15 million ahead of everybody else. So in other words, what you keep telling me that Tom Brady, oh, I'm happy with this. Skip Bayless, you know, you watched Tom Brady his entire career. That did not seem like a man that was happy with what the New England Patriots did. See, the reason why they didn't give
him... I think he's quietly very happy.
Skip, let me ask you a question.
Loves this.
Skip, let's just say since Carson Wentz has been in the league, who's missed more games due to injury? Carson Wentz or Tom Brady?
Well, obviously Carson Wentz.
Okay.
Like, way more.
Well,
like, what's the point?
My point is, his team believed in him and gave him the most guaranteed money. Your guy...
Foolishly.
Whoa, time out. If that was foolish, why would you give a guy that has missed no time since his knee injury in 2008, why would you not give him that kind of money?
Maybe because he didn't ask.
Look, stop it, Skip. Don't do that.
Okay, I told you yesterday, scenario, just hypothetical. If Tom Brady said right here, right now to Robert Kraft, I'm going to Cabo unless you give me $35 million to play this year. What do you think would happen?
Coach Belichick say bye.
Okay, he might say bye, but
bye.
Daddy would say hello.
Coach Belichick. let that sink in for a second. You said that's the GOAT. You tell me every day. You hit me over the head with a hammer. You open
Do you disagree?
Head, and then you pull GOAT.
Do you disagree?
I'm not talking about that. It's my turn to talk.
Okay.
I'm talking now.
You know
you. You tell me every single day, Tom Brady is the GOAT. Well, that's not how they look at him, because GOATish don't play on one-year deals. That doesn't happen, Skip Bayless. And you just told me that Carson Wentz, he can't stay healthy, the safety net is gone, and they gave him the $108 million guaranteed.
Mm-hmm.
Your guy with 6 Super Bowls and 4 Super Bowl MVPs is on a year-to-year deal. Mm. And you tell me he's happy with that? Everybody wants security, even Tom Brady. Mm-mm. And the Patriots says, you gets none here, bruh.
Mm. I think Tom's okay when it comes to money. I could be wrong.
No.
He does okay at home. His wife does pretty well.
Okay,
Skip. He's already done really well.
He's done great.
He's still making $23 million, even though it's tied for 7th in quarterback money.
Let me ask you this. If he was going to play till he's 45, and the Patriots are so convinced, mm-hmm. the guy hadn't been hurt in over a decade.
Yep.